Wow, hello guys! First person in the comments to tell me what this word means gets a free t-shirt of the beard variety as soon as we make them. Type away, go! Good afternoon, guys! Welcome to Life of Polish, home of the most trusted beard in automotive news. Happy to have you here! Whoa, do we have a crazy episode in store for you guys today. Thank you so much for taking a couple minutes out of your day to spend here with me. We're gonna ratchet down on some hypercar speculation, and yes, we're gonna be telling you about a brand new supercar coming to the Daily Driven Exotics channel, and no, I'm not talking about Dave's new Huracan. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel, guys. Help the beard army grow stronger. All right, guys, into our first story. All right, guys, first story up today is one that you probably missed because most people did. A lot of you guys watched the story today. Dave from Daily Driven Exotic got an incredible new Lamborghini Huracan. They teased it for a couple days. We did an episode on it like 4 days ago or so, talking about all the different cars it could be, the Lusso, the C8, the Portofino, but he ended up getting a black Lamborghini Huracan. It's awesome to see Dave have that car. Obviously the Huracan is an incredibly capable and modifiable vehicle. I think it'll be fantastic for Dave and the rest of the channel, even though they already had the Tire Slayer on it. But surprisingly, we're not actually going to be talking about the new Huracan. We're actually going to be talking about a new supercar for Damon that he sort of sneakily revealed on a live stream with Gintani just a couple days ago. Here's the footage.
What's cracking, man?
Well, I told you, I want to buy a 720, but I don't want to be getting beat by certain cars. So when can we build the motor?
Yes, we can build the motor.
Beat me on the... Right after your car,
look,
put the DD 720. Can I just send you a 720 motor? I'm tired of my slow-ass Huracan.
So as you guys can tell, there's an absolute ton of talk about getting the McLaren 720 and taking that particular stock 720 and taking it to way over 1,000 horsepower in terms of the build. Now, what's interesting about Damon getting a McLaren 720S is, first of all, obviously you guys know the 720S, one of the most capable supercars on the planet, probably the most capable supercar under $1 million. And some of the tuned versions of 720Ss are just absolute quarter mile and track behemoths. So the question remains is, if Damon gets a 720S, are we going to see a build unlike anything else, very similar to the twin turbo F12 build that's going on right now? Can you imagine what Daily Driven Exotics is going to look like if they have the twin turbo F12, a crazy over 1,000 horsepower McLaren 720S among all their other cars? It'll be a completely different kind of channel. I almost feel like it's very sort of Hoonigan-esque in that way. So you guys heard it. What do you guys think about a McLaren 720S coming to the Daily Driven Exotics channel? Put it in the comments right now. Is it time to see another McLaren? Obviously, we have the crazy top mount exhaust McLaren MP4 12C, and that seems to be relatively well received, considering that mostly McLarens have not been a true winner for the supercar world in terms of viewership. Lamborghini's far more popular, but would a 720S change that? Let me know in the comments below what you think about it. It's a brand new era for DDE, though. All right, guys, in our next story, a lot of you probably thought I was going to do, but I have to kind of put the kibosh on how we talk about it just a little bit. A lot of you guys sent me James's latest video of the Strad Man. If you guys don't know him, I don't know how you wouldn't know him at this point, but James got on very early in his video when he was starting up his Lamborghini Aventador and basically said there's no way they would ever sell the Aventador unless, well, here's the clip.
Like I said, we're never, ever, ever gonna sell the Aventador unless we get a Veneno. Whoa.
Now, obviously he's talking about the Lamborghini Veneno, an incredible, extraordinarily limited, we'll call it a hypercar within Lamborghini. And a lot of you are like, oh my gosh, this must be the car that James is looking at buying for his hypercar purchase. In the short time since James put out that video, I've received over 100 Instagram DMs. Obviously, a lot of you guys think that he's gonna be buying a Veneno as his hypercar. I'm sad to inform you that no, the Veneno is not in the cards, as much as I'm sure he would love it to be. He's even talked about getting the Veneno in multiple Instagram posts over the course of the last couple weeks. But sadly to inform you guys, since there's only, I believe, 5 coupes and 9 roadsters in the world, and they hardly ever go up for sale, and when they do go up for sale, they tend to run about $5 to $6 million at the low end. No, James is not gonna be getting a Lamborghini Veneno anytime soon. He'd have to liquidate all of his cars and his house dreams and probably the next couple years of YouTube to even begin to be able to afford something that crazy. He actually talked about sort of his price range the other day, talking about, you know, $1.3 million, about the sort of the height of where he'd want to look for a hypercar. A Veneno, completely out of the realm of possibility, at least for now. The crazy thing is, you know, give James a couple years, give that channel the ability to get to maybe 2 to 3 million views a video, which is absolutely doable as the automotive community grows. Maybe there is a Veneno in the future for his channel, but it's not gonna be for any time soon, especially if you think about how he talked about the LaFerrari and how that was way out of the price range too. We're talking about something that could be $2 million over the price of a LaFerrari. So I'm very sorry if you guys were one of the people that messaged me saying like, look, James is gonna sell the Aventador, he's gonna get a Veneno. No, that's not gonna be happening, at least not for the next couple years at bare minimum. But I do wanna tell you guys something pretty cool. Now, I can't give you guys the entire info about what I'm about to talk about, but let me tell you this. James has been talking to an extraordinarily famous YouTuber in the automotive scene about what hypercar he's looking to buy. And given who that person is, I think we might have a very small inclination about what hypercar he's actually going to do. Now, I can't say anything more. I don't want to spoil anything I'm not supposed to be talking about, but that's pretty much all I can say right now, guys. But get very, very excited. If I'm able to bring this to you in a more concrete way, I definitely will over the next week or so, hopefully much sooner. But get excited, guys. I think the hypercar he's going to be going with is going to blow your guys' mind. And make sure to let me know in the comments below what hypercar you think he should be buying. I want to know what your guys' take is on that. Now, our next story is kind of funny. Doug DeMuro, obviously killing it like always with his monster million hit plus videos every time he puts up a review, actually has a little bit of duplication, but no one seems to mind whatsoever. If you guys remember a couple years ago, he did a fantastic Porsche Carrera GT video, and he's actually duplicated pretty much that exact same video, and everyone loves it. I guess when you reach a certain number of years within YouTube, you sort of have to go back and start doing, you know, work maybe you've already done, especially in sort of the review game that Doug DeMuro does. But no one's complaining because the review is fantastic and it has a little bit of a different angle. So make sure to go check it out, guys. Doug DeMuro's second Porsche Carrera GT sort of review, we'll put that in quotation marks, but overview of why it's one of his favorite cars of all time. Make sure to check it out. Next up, guys, a very comical yet informative video from Donut Media on fixing a leak for the power steering rack on one of the cars that they work on. Make sure to go check this out, guys. Donut Media continually finding new ways to bring interesting information in their very Donut Media sort of presentation style that they do. Extraordinarily well-reviewed video, and as soon as you watch the first 2 minutes of it, you'll know exactly why that is. Make sure to go check it out, guys. Link for that in the description below. Our next story, guys, might seem boring on the surface, but a lot of you true car nuts will flock to this video extraordinarily soon. Engineering Explained doing an entire video on brand new development brakes from Porsche and how they're sort of breaking the brake industry with brand new tech. It's actually a fantastic video going over where brake technology is headed right now, and I think you guys will really enjoy it. It'll at least give you a fun piece of info to bust out at parties. Check them out, guys. And oddly, there's a segue from that story into our next one. The Straight Pipes have just a phenomenal review on the brand new Porsche 911 Turbo S. One of the most well-engineered cars on the planet, the Straight Pipes, as you guys know, one of my favorite car review channels, just no nonsense, you know, awesome stuff up front. If you guys don't follow the Straight Pipes, you're missing out on one of the best review channels, period. They're just about to hit 1 million subs extraordinarily soon. Go over there, sub to their channel, get them over the hump, and watch the review. You'll become a fan pretty instantly. Next up, guys, kind of a fun collaboration piece between Royalty Exotic Cars and Edmond Mondi, sort of doing an entire video on the new Ferrari F8 Tribe Buto, a car that I actually had the pleasure to review right before it released. Incredible car. Reminds me a lot of the McLaren 720S. Felt just as fast and well-engineered as that. Obviously doesn't have the fantastic doors, but there's so much to like in the F8 Tributo. Make sure to go check it out, guys. Royalty Exotics always getting in the craziest cars and doing videos on it as soon as they get in. Check them out. And folks, I think that's about all I've got for you guys today. Although I probably should mention, because this is a car channel in ways, and I've been talking about new vlogs forever, that I'm in the process process of buying a brand new vehicle for the channel, and it'll be something completely different than I expected to buy. If you guys have been following my channel for a little while, you'll probably know what I was looking at, and I kind of went in an exact opposite direction, for better or for worse. We're certainly gonna see. I'm gonna require a lot of your guys' help to kind of go forward in how we proceed with this, but I hope you guys will like it. It certainly seems like you've liked it on other, actually I shouldn't say that because I might give it away. Anyway, have a fantastic day. We'll catch you guys later. Make sure to stay safe, sane, and healthy, and make sure to stay tuned over the next couple days for a big car announcement. That's all I got, guys. See you later. Bye.